I'm Ana Cabrera in New York, and we have breaking news right now. The first real meaningful test of where Democratic voters are leaning as they look over and consider the more than 20 men and women who want to run against President Donald Trump. The CNN Des Moines Register poll, and the results are in. This is no ordinary poll. This is the gold standard for Iowa polling, and this is why it matters. In the last four U.S. presidential elections, when there was no Democratic incumbent running, the man or woman who won the Iowa Democratic caucuses went on to become the Democratic nominee. And as you know, there is no Democrat in the White House today. Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, John Kerry, Al Gore, no Democrat incumbent. They won the Iowa caucuses. They became the nominee. Now, the results you're about to hear point to who Iowa's Democratic voters like most right now, what they like most in their candidates, and even how they feel about the idea of impeaching President Trump. This is big, the CNN Des Moines Register poll. Let's go straight to Des Moines, Iowa. Our political director, David Chalian, is there. David, there's a lot of data in your hands right now, but we all want to know the big headline. More than 20 candidates jostling for the Democratic nomination. Who is leading?
Ana Cabrera, let me just say, you set this up correctly. Let's get right to those numbers and just show the standings right now in the horse race. Here you see Joe Biden leading the field in Iowa at 24%. Sanders follows at 16%, with Warren at 15, Buttigieg at 14, and Harris at 7% there. Just note, this is Joe Biden with a lead, but it is not as big of a lead that we've seen in recent national polls. And then you see a real bunched up between the other three, sort of virtually tied for second place there, Sanders, Warren, and Buttigieg. I do want to note here what this represents. This is likely Democratic caucus goers. And the Iowa Democratic Party, which runs the process here, is changing their rules this cycle. They're allowing for both in-person attendance, the regular way we know about Iowa caucusing, but also for the first time, they're allowing for virtual caucusing for those people that can't participate on that Monday night next February in their regularly scheduled in-person caucus. And it is weighted. 90% of the result is going to be based on that in-person attendance, the traditional way. 10% of that final result is going to be ascribed to everyone that comes to participate virtually. This poll, this CNN Des Moines Register poll, accounts for those new rules and applies that weight. So this is the likely Democratic caucus universe here. And you see here Joe Biden out in front, and you see a bunched up race for second place there. We also asked about second choice and which candidates are out there. As you said, there are 23 that you're actively considering. And I think this is such a telling number, Ana. You see here 61% for Biden, 61% for Warren, 56 Sanders, 52 Buttigieg, 52 Harris, and then Booker and O'Rourke. But you see those top five above 50% that are either your first or second choice, or you're actively considering that person. That shows that Iowa Democrats are still very much shopping around for candidates. And here's one potential warning sign for Joe Biden, and what is a good poll for Joe Biden. We checked in on if you feel extremely enthusiastic about your first choice candidate. And among those in-person caucus attendees, if you're a Biden backer, 29% of them say they are extremely enthusiastic. Compare that to the rest of the field. Any other candidate that is your first choice, not Joe Biden, 39% of those Iowa Democrats are extremely enthusiastic about that choice. And that number goes even further up in that Buttigieg, Warren, Sanders second tier there. So Joe Biden, just a bit of a warning sign that there may be an enthusiasm gap where his competitors may have a bit of an advantage there, Ana.
And David, what does the polling show us about what voters are looking for in these candidates?
Right, so when we gave voters a choice in this poll, the decision between choosing a Democratic nominee who has a strong chance to win, to defeat Donald Trump, and one that agrees with you in your positions, it's not even close. 65% of likely Democratic caucus goers say they want a candidate who has a strong chance to win. Only 31% say to share my issue positions. We also tested some other candidate qualities. We provided a longer list. And this is really interesting, and I think is going to be part of the conversation about what the Democrats are trying to sell to Iowans as they're campaigning here. Integrity is the top candidate quality, 56% looking for that, 40% looking for intelligence, 34% leadership, and 25% there's that electability fact again. And I also just want to note, since the conversation in Washington has been all about impeachment, and Nancy Pelosi may be feeling some pressure from her left flank on this, take a look at these numbers. Among Iowa caucus-going Democrats, likely Iowa Democratic caucus-goers, Nancy Pelosi seems on the right side right now. 42% say the Congress should begin impeachment immediately. They'd be shirking their responsibilities not to do so. But the plurality, 48% of these Democrats say, continue with the investigations, but do not move to impeachment right now. Anna.
David, we talked at the top just how important Iowa is. Now we know where the race stands in the state right now. There are 19 Democrats canvassing Iowa this week, and 19 of these Democratic candidates, they're almost stepping on each other's feet, and the caucuses aren't even happening until next February. Here's just a taste of what they were up to today. Let's watch.
Whoever the next nominee is for our party, every single one of us will do all we can to make sure that she or he is successful in defeating Donald Trump.
It is about racial justice. It is about environmental justice. And it is about social justice.
It's a great day, and it's a great day to celebrate. So Dr. King told us that the arc of the moral universe bends towards justice.
So when we are marching here today, we are standing on the shoulders of people who have come before us, who have fought for us, who have suffered for us.
David, there can't be much these candidates haven't said or something similar like what we just heard before. How do they stand out? 19 are there this weekend.
Yeah, it's such a good question, and I actually think this brand new poll of ours indicates the challenge here. It is tough to break out. The great majority of these candidates don't even crack 5% in this poll. Only five candidates do crack that 5% threshold. So getting a breakthrough moment and trying to get some traction is proving extraordinarily difficult in this very crowded field. But that is precisely what these Democrats are going to look to do. The 19 who are showing up at that big Iowa Democratic Party fundraising and organizing event, the Hall of Fame event in Cedar Rapids tomorrow. They each get 5 minutes to speak and address the faithful. And believe me, if you want to look for something tomorrow, look for how each of those 19 Democrats running for president try to have a breakthrough moment before this very critical crowd.
All right, David Chalian in Des Moines, Iowa for us. Thank you, sir.